So I really should be getting ready for it. But I want to get this started. So I did put a code of Jesso on here, just in case. But we're mostly going to cover it up this music paper. So let's just get the matte medium down. Splodgy, splodgy. And I am going to cover the hearts up on this one. That's way too much medium. Never mind. Exactly where I'm going with this one, but I know I want to use this image, which is from an Alice in Wonderland book, but the illustrations are a little bit strange. You should see the one where he's shoving the mouse into the teapot. Oh my goodness, crazy. yes, and next I want to grab some of these butterflies. The annoying thing is I want the ones in the middle. Why didn't I go that way? There's no butterflies there. Ugh, goodness me, I'm silly. How many shall we have? 4, 3, 4, 5. Right. Let's see. I really love these greeny blue ones, so I definitely want those on. I know you're not really going to see much of this, but it's just to add something nice to the background. Little bit of interest. These two together and just pop them at the bottom. That might be a nice idea. Yes. So I've got like 20 minutes before I need to go to work. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I'm going to use gesso because then I can coat the whole background and it'll be ready for painting. Okay. Okay. Nice. Base coat of gesso. Put this one here. Fiddly. These two at the bottom. And you're not going to see that one actually, so I'm going to cut that. Put that one there. And that one there. And that one there. And that one there. There we go, and then we'll just have that. You can't really see the yellow ones, never mind. That's fine, they're there. We know they're there. So, I'm gonna get rid of that because it's sticky and hard. There we go. So, that needs to dry. And then I'll do something else. I don't know what, but I'll do something else. Right. I've made a decision about this. I'm actually going to tear paint on that frame. I'm going to tear around the image and get rid of some of this unwanted blank space. I'm about to decapitate the mouse's whiskers. As well. There we go. Still undecided about that tag. I don't think I want the tag. Do I want another butterfly? Too big. And another piece somewhere. This one. Right. Matte medium. Sorry. Now then. Where do I put that now? Yeah. Okay, so let's pop this butterfly up here. And then we'll pop these guys down here. I can't pick the glue up for some reason. I want to come up. It's going a bit overcast today, so I'm sorry if it's getting a bit dark. That's not sticking for some reason. I thought this flat medium would be thick enough for this. I think the tape has just absorbed it all. nice and well stuck. And we'll get rid of the excess. Right, and my next step, when that's dry, I'm going to give the whole image a coat of clear gesso. Well, obviously, you don't really need to see me paint on clear gesso. That'll bore you. Okay. I'm going to get rid of this tag because it's annoying. There we go. I just turned over the scraps from where I've torn around this picture and I found Tea Time and Hatter, so I decided to go through the book and grab some more words. So we're going to have Tea Time here. Let's put some that medium out. Oh, maybe I'll just use the gel medium because that's really annoying me today. Oops. Into the drawer. Ugh. Sorry. I hope I'm not making you feel sick. So. Got Tea Time. We've got Alice. Got Cheshire Cat. And Hatter. There we go. Now I'm going to let that dry. Put some clear gesso on, and we'll be good to go. Right, so it's all been gessoed, clear gesso. And I've got some Vallejo teal, which is an opaque colour. So I'm going to have a couple of drops of that. And then a couple of drops of my golden glazing medium. Birds are tweeting away today. Even though it's gone very dark. Just hoping I don't need to put my light on. I might have to put it on in a sec. If it gets any darker. Right. Now let's see if this is going to be... Okay. It's very opaque. So we'll brush it on. And then we'll grab a baby wipe. Just have them here. And we'll clean off the frame. I added some clear gesso to the frame as well. Just while I was at it. I know I did gesso it, but I just felt like adding that extra layer. Right, and now blend some of the background back in. Now I'm going to grab a clean and I'm going to go over this bit again and Alice's face again and the rabbit and the dormouse. Go. I like that. Added a bit of colour, but not too much. I love doing glazes, so much fun. Okay, so I'm going to let that dry. And I'll be back. Right. So I just want to, whilst that's drying, stamp some little things to go on it. And I'm using my clear embossing ink. This is wax paper. Not to get this too splodgy. Hopefully that looks like a nice clear impression. And then some gold embossing powder. That looks quite nice. Lid on there for a sec and emboss it. That's that one done. And there's some hot glue under there that got a bit hot. It's a little bit undefined, but never mind, you can sort of tell what it is. Oh, this doesn't stick anymore, so I have to use my hands. Da-da. There we go. So let's pop powder away. Okay, and the stamps away. Let's move these. Let's see if this is dry yet. I think that's dry enough to work on. Now, where am I going to put these? I've not used this technique before. I've seen doing errands emboss onto wax paper, so pretty confident that it will look good. Yeah. Right, now the dreaded matte medium. Let's get the mask out again. Ooh. Playing nice today. Okay. The glue spreader. There's enough glue under there. I didn't get any under there. There we go. Oops, a bit harsh there. Just trying to make sure it's still stuck. Looks pretty good to me. Same over here. went on pretty nice and easy. Wrinkles out. There we go. Just getting rid of some of the excess if I can. There we go. We'll see what that looks like when it's dry. And I've got to figure out how I want to put my lettering on. And also get rid of this brown mark up here. Let's get the gesso out. I got a fairly small brush. Got this one, let's try this. Carefully gesso over here as well. We've still got some of that teal. Of course, somebody is using the power tool outside. So, what I'll do is I'll just finish this. And I won't make you listen to that. Right, so I've cut out my letters with this Do Crafts die. This Do Crafts, isn't it? No? Make? So just cut and make. I don't know, I've cut off the top there, but that one anyway. I was hoping to get the title sort of in here, but it's going to be too big. There's no way I'm going to get all those letters in there, is there? Let's just see. If I squash this up. It's going to go over the mouse, you see. No, I think I prefer it down there now. Anyway, so I'm going to use my glossy accents that I've got in a fine tip bottle, and I'm just going to glue them down. Right, so now I'm going to pop my heat gun on. Ooh, I'll just have a lie down. That's fine. Right. These baby white flowers that I made. I Make sure I've got all of them. Yep, that's it. Okay, and let's just have a look at how I'm gonna arrange them. I'm not sure about that one because it's not in the same colour tones, if you get it. Get what I mean? Although that one does have some of that in it as well. I think I like it like that. I don't want too much. There. That looks good to me. Can you even see everything? No, you can't. Now my stomach is rumbling. Where are we going? That way. Okay. Oh, there's another one. To be honest, I like that. That balances quite nicely, I think. Let's see if this is ready yet. Oop, yeah. Okay. So, if you want to know how I made these baby white flowers, I followed Marta's tutorial. Although for this, I did cut them quite a lot smaller than she does in the video because I wanted some small blooms, so I cut the baby wipes in half and then folded them into four and cut the circles out. That glue gun. Glue this one together very well, did I? There we go. Yeah, so these are just made from baby wipes like this. I can stretch that out to dry, hang it up somewhere. Let it dry and then I can make beautiful flowers, roses like these. And just gonna make sure I've glued them together because I was a bit impatient. I wasn't gluing every layer. So before I put the gun away, give them a good tug and glue them all together. Yeah. And to make them nice and tight, I use a pair of scissors to hold it still. And then twist a little bit in the middle and it kind of scrunches the middles up. And then they've all got the same sort of little flat back pearls inside. I don't really see that one very well. It's difficult because the light's not very good. Let's see. Yeah, they're quite well in there, so And now I'm going to use a little tip from Linda Simpson, and I'm going to heat that. Just to eliminate the stringy glue. Now let me unplug that glue gun again before I drop it again. Excuse me. 1 second, there we go. Now then. I like it a lot, but I think I just want to finish off the edges. I've got a sponge there, stays on. And I'm gonna dip this in the ink, and I'm literally just gonna go a little gently. Come in a little way. A bit more. Just to give it a defining edge. Sponge soon. This one's falling to bits. I don't know how well this is going to come out on the camera, but it's just adding a delicate little interest there. Finishing it off, sort of thing. My stomach is grumbling. I think I'm going to need to go and get something to eat before I carry on. Just got quite a few stringy bits there. Try it again. There we go. And that is finished. So I thought I was done. I've just been looking at it. Was hanging up in front of me, and I've been looking at it, and I just, yeah, I think it needs some purple rather than the white. Just, yeah, oops. Just think it looks a bit better, a bit more finished. The white was kind of drawing your eye, because nothing else is white, sort of thing. So I'm hoping that this will sort of help it don't know, help you focus more on the actual. Yeah. On the images and the words. Which is where we want to focus. And I've got to stop putting my fingers in it. Because it's distressing and it's reacting to my fingers. So. I like that. Does it need anything else? Yeah. Right. Okay.